Chinese food here in the Philippines is part of our cuisine already. So there's what we call Filipino-Chinese cuisine. So these are the dishes that you find in mga pansiteria, di ba? So medyo Filipinized na ng konti yan. Sometime in the late, siguro very early 70s, that was the first time I had gone to Hong Kong. And somehow my perspective of Chinese food totally changed. So whereas before, you know, in our Filipinized Chinese restaurants or pasiteria, we would eat mga sweet and sour pork, you know, masarap na yun. Don't get me wrong, they're very, very good. But when I went to Hong Kong, it totally changed. So the dishes I'm going to cook today, at least two of them, are ones that I feel are the most authentic Cantonese Hong Kong style cuisine. So here is my recipe for sweet and sour pork. I try to make it medyo authentic Cantonese Hong Kong style. These are the ingredients that I found at home for our sweet and sour pork. First of all, our pork is pork butt that is poked, sliced into pieces, and pounded. Then we have salt, Chinese wine, egg yolks, cornstarch, salt, cooking oil, pepper, chopped onions, chopped tomatoes, strawberry jam, honey, tomato ketchup, sugar, and vinegar. We also have cubed pineapples, sliced onions, green and red bell pepper, and cornstarch. The cut of pork that we use is pork butt. You get a pork butt sliced like this, and what you do is you get gadgets. So this is one of my gadgets, okay? These are spokes. These have spokes, and you just puncture them, okay? You're trying to break the connective tissues like that, no? Now, when you set that aside, you will slice it into pieces like this. Ayan, no? Ayan. Okay. What I have also is this, okay? Get this also. Importante to eh. Pampukpuk. Okay. Now, we are going to marinate this pork before we cook it. So, we have some salt. We have some Chinese wine. Okay, we have some two egg yolks. Ayan. And we have some cornstarch. What we're going to do here is we're going to marinate our pork. Okay. I have here some pre-pounded pork already. Ayan, lagyan natin to. All of this. So we'll set up. Mix all of these together very well. What you want to do is just marinate it like this. Okay? And then I have here cornstarch. Cornstarch with salt and pepper. Mix all of these together very, very well. And what we're going to do is we will coat each piece, okay, of our pork in cornstarch. Imagine this, no? Crispy, sweet, sour, salty. That's a combination of sweet and sour pork, you know? And one of the crunchiest combination I learned from a friend of mine, si Cindy Soriano, is combination of egg white and cornstarch. Very, very crispy. So what we're going to do here is we have very hot oil and we're going to shock our pork. When you shock it, parang it will seal the outside, leave it crunchy, and it's going to retain its moisture. Okay, so let's just deep fry this. And this one, just like a Korean chicken, we're going to fry twice. So let's just wait for this to cook. Okay, this one is almost done, no? But what I want to do, look at that, oh, look at that. Look at that crisp. Okay, what I want to do is let it rest. Siguro about 2 minutes. And then what we want to do also is let that oil heat up again and then drop it and shock it again to become more crispy, okay? You give the oil time to rest a little bit and then we'll come back to this one. Now, let me start making my sauce. Now, what we're going to do is start sauteing our sauce. I have some cooking oil. Okay, onions. Yan. Red onions are stronger than the normal white onions, okay? And then, tomatoes. Actually, it's a very tedious recipe, pero, you know, you try to get the authentic taste, eh, di ba? So, that's part of the process. Okay, let's go back to our pork, no? So I've let it rest for about 2 minutes. What I want to do is shock it again. Fry again, look. Mm. Okay. Shock it again. Yo. Okay, now we're making the sauce. Onions and tomatoes. And then we're going to add in Chinese wine. Okay. Chinese wine. Now, here's something that's totally new to me. You know what it is? Strawberry jam. Or any kind of jam will do. Okay, just to add a little fruity flavor to the sweet and sour sauce. Okay. Yeah, so there's a little sweetness already, no? Then, oh, I can imagine this already. Mm. Now, we're going to add some honey. Okay. You know, honey pala, I didn't know. The one way to test if it's good honey, you should get cold water, you drop a tablespoon on that water, and the moment the honey sinks to the bottom, that's the indicator that it's good quality honey. Now, ketchup naman, tomato ketchup lang. Okay. Some sugar. Okay. Some salt. Yeah, taro. Oh, exciting. And then water. Okay. And what we will do is we'll just wait for our veggies to cook or mix and blend all the flavors. Yan. So this one is done. I'm going to set this aside. Okay. Okay, at this point, you have to strain all the liquid. So I've extracted all the flavors of the tomatoes, yung onions. But you know what they do in Hong Kong is they make this in quantity. So it's not as if you're going to do this every time you cook a sweet and sour pork, no? What I wanna do is taste again, okay? Taste again. Oh, that's so good. But you know what's missing? The vinegar. Okay, so let's add in our vinegar. Okay, don't touch it, let it breathe. And then we're gonna add in our red onions, red and green bell peppers. Okay, just cook this until it's nice and done. Actually, the thickness already, you have to eyeball this, no? Now, at this point, what you wanna do is check for the red and green bell peppers and the onions. The moment they're done, then we can add in our crispy pork on the side already. Now, the sauce looks like it's thick enough, okay? But what I'll do, I'll add a little slurry. That's a combination of cornstarch and water, just for it to thicken a little bit. Yan. Wow, galing. Ooh. Okay, look at this, oh. It's nice and crunchy. So what you do, finale, is just add in the pork. That's it. That's it. And mix all of these together. I can still feel the crunch. Wow. That's it. Oh my gosh. Add in pala, may pineapple. Eh, forget it all about. No, yan na yan. Anyway, at least adding it last also will make the flavor still stand out. No? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. And look at this. Tell me if this doesn't look authentic. Look at that. Ooh. Mm. You know what? It's still crispy. That's the authentic Hong Kong sweet and sour pork. Sarap. Mm. Now it's time to cook our fish and chicken together into one dish. Why? Because why not? Salted fish fried rice with chicken, coming up on Casa Daza. Okay, this recipe naman, I discovered when I was in Hong Kong. We would frequent Hong Kong before. One of my friends, Sinito Tayag, who loves to eat. Oh, it's like a very good friend of mine, he introduced me to this dish which I'd never tried before. I remember it was in a restaurant along Nathan Road called Tsuyang Village. He ordered, "Can you give me salted fish fried rice?" You know, the moment I tried it, I fell in love with it. Let me show you how to make this, okay? Here are the ingredients for our salted fish fried rice with chicken. We have chicken fillet cut into small cubes, oyster sauce, sesame oil, cornstarch, cooking oil, and grated ginger. Then we have daing, oil, chicken cube, eggs, rice, green peas, soy sauce, and spring onions. Very first ingredient for our salted fish fried rice is we have some oyster sauce, okay? In all the restaurants in Chinatown, when I was in Vancouver, I watched them how to make this. So sesame oil, oyster sauce, sesame oil, cornstarch, okay? Yeah. Mix all of these ingredients together very, very well. The moment you find that uniform color, okay, then you can add in, look at that color, oh. Diba? So that means the sesame oil and the oyster sauce have blended well. What you want to do is add in our chicken. Okay, so marinate our chicken there. And then what we will do is we will let it rest for about, let's say about 30 minutes. Anyway, this is chicken breast, you know, so it's absorbed all that liquid. And what we're going to do is just saute this chicken. Okay, saute the chicken in hot oil until it's nice and cooked. Okay. Let's just saute our chicken first. Okay, until this is nice and done. Nabilis maluto ito eh. Okay, so now what I'm doing now is I'm just cooking the marinated chicken because remember, it's called salted fish fried rice with chicken. So it's very important that you have a balance of the rice and the salted fish because the salted fish can be very overpowering. So you have to be careful. Okay, so at this point, we are going to... This is chicken fillet anyway, so this one is done. We'll just set this aside, okay? Okay, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to cook our salted fish, okay? So I have some cooking oil again. I'm going to put some ginger naman. And the ginger, what it does is it removes the fishy flavor of our salted fish, okay? Just extract the flavor. Ayan. Then remove the ginger, okay? Oh, yan na. I can smell the aroma of the ginger na. Okay? So I just got the drippings of the ginger just so that we will cook our salted fish in this oil. Okay? Ayan. Okay? Fry it. You know what will happen here is when you fry it also, the salted fish will intensify in flavor. You have to make sure that it's very, very small, not too big, because it can be very overpowering. Okay? We're gonna set this aside. Okay? Set our salted fish aside, right beside our chicken. Yan. Okay. And remember, the oil has the flavor of the ginger and the salted fish, right? So we're still gonna use that. And I'm gonna put a chicken cube. You know what they do also? If you notice the fried rice in Hong Kong, yung mga yang chow and the salted fish fried rice, the flavors are very, very subtle. So I love that. Ano, parang you're trying to, oh my gosh, what is that? Yung pala, chicken powder. Okay, so, and then what we're going to do, we're adding our egg. Okay. Yan. And we will cook this until it's nice and yung half cooked. Yan. So at this point, you just add in the rice. Ooh, okay. So this is medyo cold rice already. But what you want to do is when you add a little vapor from the heat of our oil and the egg and everything, you know, it's going to steam and it's going to soften. Then we can mix the rice, okay? I'll show you. You know, a while ago, the lumps of rice were a little bit tough. But like I mentioned, the moment you add a little vapor to that, it softens up. And you make sure there are no lumps in your fried rice. I hate that, di ba? Okay, so at this point, you know what you want to watch out for also, the signs. Because sometimes, you get a nice wok, by the way. Sometimes the rice bounces, parang it jumps because of the, you're doing the right thing. Now, at this point, okay, I don't expect this to taste much, but... You know, there is a very subtle flavor from the chicken cube, you remember? Now, at this point, we want to return our salted fish, our chicken, okay? Remember? And then, green peas, okay? So, slowly, there's yellow, there's green, and we're slowly putting flavor in this salted fish fried rice, okay? So, we will mix. Look at that, oh. You notice slowly it became alive because of the color, the contrast of green. Now, you know me sometimes, whenever I eat in a restaurant and they serve me, di ba yung individual bowls, which I find kind of bitin, and I find that the flavor is a little bit subtle. What I do is I have on the side some soy sauce, okay? So let me taste this. Okay, nice na. Oh my gosh, it's so good. But, I have here some soy sauce. I'm gonna dab a little bit. Okay, you hear that? You hear that, the sound of the fried rice? You said, oh, I love that soy sauce, and give me more. But you know, very subtle lang, very subtle, not too much. Okay, so I've added the soy sauce. You know, there are two things you can do actually. You remember when I first tasted it without putting the salted fish and the chicken? Parang okay na in taste, but slightly bitin. So instead of adding the soy sauce, I suggest, instead of putting one chicken cube, put two. Okay, so now, let us plate this. Look at that. Topped with chopped spring onions. Wow. You know what? You can have an authentic Chinese meal at home. Sweet and sour pork, salted fish fried rice. Boom! Sarap niya.
Sarap.
We still have shrimps, so I thought of preparing some shrimp cocktail. A delicious and light appetizer from the UK. Up next, here at Casa Daza. Okay, this recipe, we used to serve this in a French restaurant in Manila long ago. Siguro, the French restaurant, we used to call it Bon Vivant. It was the top French restaurant at that time. You know, I was a kid, so I had no idea what it was. But I realized later on, I just remember, I see yung mga personalities, popular people, mga dignitaries, they would go there and say, what did they find about this restaurant? Yung pala, it was one of the top restaurants. And I remember, I just learned a couple of years after that we would bring in Michelin star chefs in Bon Vivant. And that's where I got exposed to very good French food. I had no idea. One of the dishes there was this dish called shrimp cocktail. Sometimes, when you have appetizers in a party and a get together, parang you're thinking, racking your brains, what can I bring? You know what? This is something that is overlooked, but it's so simple to make and it's so good. This is a really quick appetizer to prepare. We will only need shrimps that have already been steamed, peeled, and cleaned, tomato ketchup, celery, onion, calamansi or lemon juice, Worcestershire sauce, and sriracha sauce. So what I've done is I steamed the shrimp for about 15 minutes, okay? Remove the head, remove the legs, remove the shell, and I just pick it up like this, oh. And I leave the tail on, okay? And then chill it in the refrigerator. It's very sensitive. You have to keep it in the refrigerator right away. And all we have to do is just a matter of mixing all the ingredients together. I have some tomato ketchup. Yan. Okay. This is so, so good. You may use also, by the way, you may use steamed mussels here also. Okay. We have some chopped celery. We have some chopped onions, finely chopped red onions. Lemon juice or calamansi juice, what have you. We have Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire sauce. Ito medyo, the flavor is going to be very, very subtle. And then we have hot sauce. What I put is I put sriracha sauce. This one I discovered recently. A friend of mine, si Sandra Bellica, she gave me a bottle of Tabasco sriracha flavor. Oh my gosh, it was so good. So good. Yeah, no? Look at that. Okay, now, at this point, all you have to do is mix it together. Mix it together. Look at that. Look at that. Yo. This is the type of sauce that when you try it, you're going to talk to yourself. You know, sometimes when it's so masarap, you talk to yourself. Well, I do that at least. Okay, so here it is. So good. Mmm, a little bit spicy. Mmm, sarap. Very, very simple to make. Shrimp cocktail. You have to try this at home. I don't know if you notice about the recipes that I make here in the show. No, I make sure, number one, that they're delicious. I kitchen test all of them. Number two, the ingredients have to be easy to find. They don't necessarily have to be expensive. The procedure is very simple. I try to simplify it so that everybody can do it. And you know, it's nice to have restaurant quality food and you can cook it at home. You know, it's going to make you feel proud, especially when you can serve it to your loved ones and they tell you, Ma or Dad, sarap. Now, the three recipes that I did today, sweet and sour pork. This is an authentic Hong Kong Cantonese style sweet and sour pork, okay? Number one. The second one is an authentic Cantonese salted fish fried rice also, and it is so good. The third one has no connection between the two, but one thing that's similar in these three recipes, they're all very, very good. So try this shrimp cocktail. You have to try this at home. So there you have it. These are simple, delicious, authentic recipes that you can cook at home. I'll see you again here in Casa Daza. Bye, thank you.